Hello folks, I'm Scott Grove. Today I'm going to teach you how to play beginner, lap steel or dobro, guitar in for beginners in country, but we're using, okay, so I'm going to give you a few pointers here right off the bat so you can know what you need before you get your video, okay, so instead of the video getting there, then you realize you got to go out and get a bunch of stuff, okay. First of all, I'm going to explain to you what this is. Right now, I'm going to actually teach the whole lesson on my lap steel. And C6 tuning, as I bring this down, is the tuning that they use for like the original Hank Williams type songs, where you would get like the... Okay, so that... Okay, so that is the kind of sounds we're getting. Now your regular tuned dobro tuning is a lot different than that. So again, pardon me while I use my camera guy here. this C6 tuning is very Western sounding as opposed to more blues sounding like the typical dobro tuning. Now when it comes time to get, if you're gonna get a lap steel, I highly recommend instead of getting something vintage, unless that's what you already have, that's fine. This is a 6-string. They make lap steels in 6-string and 8-string. A lot of people, if they have 8-strings, they just pull 2 strings off. Okay? So this is for a 6-string lesson. This is a PV power slide. $199 delivered. You get your slide, you get your gig bag, you get a strap for it, you get humbucker sounds, you get single coil, just all kinds of different sounds. The best guitar on the market for the money. Okay, the other thing that you really need to have, number one, like I said, it will come with a tone bar or your slide bar. They look like this, so you'll need to have one of those. Okay, now you have to decide. You can get those on eBay or your local music store. It's not a slide bar for guitar. It's meant for your dobro or your lap steel. It's not for steel guitar either. This is not for pedal steel anyway. You also, if you want to go the standard method, decide on, and I don't do it because I don't do it. Everybody has a preference. If you want to incorporate finger picks and thumb picks, I'll get my fancy camera guy. There he is. Okay. So which is basically instead of using your fingers, which I like to use. Okay. So you can actually be using these. So if you need to get them, go out and get them. You can see how to put them on. You just put them on, bend them around. Two of them go on your fingers, and you just kind of bend them around your fingers. And then you get your thumb pick. Okay, so people will actually... I don't use them because I'm not very good at it. Plus, I just don't like the sound of the things. But you decide what you want to do. You can even play it with a guitar pick for... all that goes. Okay, the other thing is that you'll want to make sure is do not buy a regular set of guitar strings for these. Okay, so if you're using a lap steel, do not buy guitar strings for them. And do not buy just lap steel strings and think that whatever they are is going to work on there for this kind of tuning because it will not. You need to get non-pedal steel guitar strings. Okay, this is 6 strings. For not the pedal. If you get the pedal steel strings, you're up a creek without a paddle again. And they better be for C6 because the gauge of the strings is a huge factor here. So again, make sure they are for electric. They are 6 strings, not for a pedal steel guitar. And that they are actually specifically made for a C6 tuning. Okay? If you will be using a dobro, exact same thing. Here's the dobro. You've seen these. If that's what you have, cool. But they take the acoustic strings, not regular acoustic guitar strings. But again, same thing. C6 tuning for dobro, 6-string dobro for a C6 tuning. strings. So you got to get the right strings and the right gear for what's going on here. Okay, so that's basically what you're going to need. I'm going to cover this. We're going to stay with traditional country because that's what this whole thing's about. We're going to go right from the beginning like you've never touched this instrument before. So if you are somewhat familiar with guitar, great. But I will be going at a slow pace for people who have not ever touched this instrument. Okay, so when you do pick up this video, make sure you pick up all this other stuff. One last thing, if you go out and get yourself a tuner, which I highly recommend, do not get a basic guitar tuner. Reason being is if you find one, make sure that it will actually tune up a C note. All the regular guitar tuners will not do it. Okay, they'll do your E, A, D, G, B, and then again E, but they don't have no place for a C. There's two C strings on this guitar. They got to be able to tune it up. These won't do it. So you got to find one that is made that has the C's and the weird notes, the F's and the C sharps, and make sure it will cover all 12 notes. Okay, so little $15 tuners will work, but you got to get the ones that actually have those notes on them. Once again, just a quickie, we're going to do the classic country sounding stuff. Nothing but, okay? So we'll learn all the typical stuff, the names of all those strings, but right into the meat and potatoes so you don't have to get bored. So we're going to learn how to do the fun stuff. You'll learn the single note stuff too that you'll need. Okay, so just your little stuff that you're going to have. But yeah, basically you're... Okay, and some Hawaiian sounding things, but we'll... discover everything that the instrument can do for you. So I'm coming back up with my fancy guitar, or my fancy camera tech. Pardon me while I don't shave. I don't have time to shave every day because I'm constantly making videos for y'all. So once again, we're going to do dobro and lap steel in C6 tuning, classic country licks, and I will explain every little thing for the, pardon the expression, for the guitarded people out there who have never played anything, or if you've been a guitar player and you're wanting to tackle this, but in the C6 tuning, this is the video for you. We're going to get the good old traditional old 40s, 30s, 20s, 50s era steel guitar sounds. That's what they used back then, the cowboy stuff. Okay, so once again, Scott Grove, C6 tuning time. This will be the first video. There'll be more. But this will get you introduced to it. Okay, so hang on and grab your supplies before the videos get there. Otherwise, you'll be surprised. I know, bad joke. Catch you in a bit. Okay, folks, welcome back. It's time for lap steel slash dobro classic country C6 guitar. We're doing the good old-fashioned stuff. Okay, now hopefully you went out and got everything that I had told you to go grab. Hopefully you have a tuner, and maybe you're already tuned up. Okay, if you're not, you can tune up with me. Okay, let's get the names of these strings out of the way. Okay, what we have is our lowest string, the one that is closest to you, is actually your C. Okay, so that is C. Ergo, the name C6. There's another C here. So there's a couple of them. A couple of these are actually repeated, but octaves higher. So there's C. You can tune up to me using your tuning keys. But hopefully, like I said, you got that tuner. Otherwise, you don't have to go through this mess. That's why I warned you in advance. You'll need this. Okay, your fifth string is your E. These make sense in a minute, why they have the names and why I give them to you, because you have to know your notes. Your next one is your G string, nobody laugh. That's your fourth string, your G string. your next one is your A string. That's your third string. Okay, now you have another C string, which is going to be string number two. I'm doing this to have you tune up with me. So if you gotta tune it up and you don't have a tuner, that's why I'm doing this. Only for those who didn't listen and didn't go out and buy one. That's right, I'll yell at you. And finally, another E string, the one furthest away from you. Okay, now you have another E string down here, that fifth one. So you can kind of tell that they're the same string. Same as your C here, your low one, and the C here. So you have your E. Your first and fifth are the same, but different tune, but different octaves, and same with the next two, your fifth or your sixth string and your second. So again, you have C, E, G, then we spell ace. A, C, E. Okay? So if you think of keg, but spell it wrong, keg, C-E-G, then ace. So keg, C-E-G, if you funk spelling, then ace, A-C-E. Okay, those are the names of your strings. Okay, now the thing we're going to work on right now is you decide what you're going to use, if you're going to use your fingers, as I do, because that's my preference, and I'm allowed to do so. Or if you want to use thumb picks and finger picks. Now, if you are going to use thumb picks and finger picks, okay, your thumb pick, this guy, will actually go on with the pick part, or the pointy end, actually facing the front of your thumb here, or the part of your thumb you would press down or something with. It points like that. Okay? Don't mind the circle in the middle. It's just a little device. Okay? So that will go on that way, onto your thumb, and wrap around. Once again, your finger picks, the steel ones that you, if you're going to go this route, simply fit on the ends of your fingers. You wrap around these parts and just bend them. They're aluminum. They're not actually steel or nothing, I don't think. But stick them on there, get them so they fit tight, but not so much that your fingertips are going to turn purple. And then just bend up the pick part over top of the ends of your fingers. So they will end up looking like this. You take them off, don't bend anything. It's going to be shaped to that finger. One finger's bigger than the other. Look which one it was. And yep, that one's bigger and didn't quite squeeze all the way, so I know that one's from my middle finger. Okay, so you would actually use your thumb pick as like this to pick a note, usually one of your lower notes, while your other fingers are just reaching down and doing this. So you can pick three notes at a time, if you wish to. If I was using the bar, which I'll show you how to do in a second, and using these picks, or you can pick them. The sound you get from the pick is a real hard, it's what's called attack. So it's like, it really bites at you. That's called your attack. Now, if you choose not to use them, then you will get a much softer attack. Okay, I'm going to pan out just a little bit and you'll hear the difference, and then you can decide which way you want to go. Also, the reason I don't tend to use them is because I jump from one instrument to another really fast and I don't just have time to put them on. Okay. So I get to jump down here, play a solo, then jump back on keyboards or jump on another instrument. So I just don't have the time to sit there and put them on. So you heard that before with the picks. Here it is without. I actually think it sounds better without it myself, but 99% of the population in the world use the picks. Okay? So that's as much as I'll cover on that. You decide which way to go, and I showed you how to play with each one. Now we will actually start talking grips and grabbing different combinations of strings. Okay, the thing we have here, we'll grab a few of these. I want you to actually start by, we'll do this. We'll come in nice and close. I want you to take your thumb on your third string, okay, or your A string, your first finger, right here on your C string, and finally, your middle finger on, okay, right here on your high E. And I want you to play them all together at the same time. So we have a grouping here. So this is one group. And then we are muting, which is what we call it, if we put our fingers just back on the strings to stop it. You won't be doing this all the time. Sometimes you want to let them ring. That will be when we're using like the slide bar, and you want to slide it and make it ring. But if you wanted to stop something, then you mute it, okay? You can also do that by placing the palm of your hand back down on the string, okay? So on the strings behind here, okay? So there's muting. You can just put your hand back, fingers back on the strings, or put your, rest your hand behind it. Okay, so that is just one single grouping, is those three strings, your A, C, E, your ace grouping. You can go down and get your keg, your C, E, G. That's just another one. That is actually a regular C chord. There's nothing as far as a sixth goes, which is, you know, the C6 tuning, nothing that makes that come into play. So this is just a regular C. They call this a triad. That's tri, three notes, and try to play three notes. And they're all three different notes. So that's another grouping. Do this to all your strings. So here's, I'm gonna call them by the string numbers. 6, 5, 5, 4, 6, 5, 4. Now we'll do 5, 4, 3. Reason this one sounds weird is because of this A string. That's the one you gotta watch out for, okay? Your A string, I pointed that out to you earlier. So from your highest to your lowest, 1, 2, 3, that's your third string. That's what makes everything into a sixth. Okay, so unless you want it to sound like a sixth chord, which I'll show you what it is, that's the one that gets weird and is hard to work around, but then again, it is the magic of this tuning. Okay, so there's 5, 4, and 3. Now we'll do 4, 3, and 2, which sounds cool. That's where you're going to get your Western swing sounding stuff, is that grouping. 4, 3, 2, okay? So you get your G, A, okay? And your C, okay? And then again, your first position here, or your ace. That is actually what's called an A minor chord. Okay, just for future reference, that A minor, you're going to be needing some minor chords in some of your songs that you play, not just major chords. Major chords, or if you skip over top of that third string and actually grab 5, 4, and 2, it's still a C major chord. And as long as you skip that third string on all these triads. You can skip all the strings you want. So now I'm playing four, two, one. Those are all C major chords. Okay, and then skip over that again. So those are all C chords, they're all valid. But as soon as you throw this in, along with, then all of a sudden it becomes an A minor. Now this is going to be weird and sound funny to people who have not ever played before. That's called your relative minor. What it means is that you are actually allowed to play A minor and C, or C, or C, or C. Anything but that string is a C, but then you're allowed to play A minor with it during these cowboy chord things, this C6 stuff. So relative minor means it is actually related to and almost identical in every note in it to a C chord. So your A, that's why they put it all right there. So if you're playing everything open, which means you're not using your bar or anything, means you're playing it with nothing, I'll pan out. So here's a C chord. Okay, that's your C, E, G. Now play A, C, E, your ace. Okay, so they're allowed to be in the same thing. That's why they tune this instrument this way, because everything is actually relative or related to each other. So you can't really play a bad note, except for the exception of that third string, that A string, that gets kind of in the way now and then. We'll come across that as we go. Okay, now to actually make music. Enough with the yakking. Let's get right in here and make some noise and start having some fun. Then we'll work on what is called theory and why things work. But let's make some music now, okay? Your steel guitar bar, okay, that should look like this. May or may not have a hole. If you got the one that came with this guitar, it's actually hollowed out in the middle, which is fine. As long as you got one and it's not some big round thing. If you want to use the round ones, fine. If you got it by mistake, fine. But this works out great because your first finger, your pointy finger, index finger, lays right in the top of that groove. That's what it's there for. Your middle finger lays on the side of it. And your thumb goes into the other groove. That's why it's made this way. So that you can hold it like this and you can pick it up. With a regular round bar, if you bought it by mistake, it's going to be hard for you to pick it up. Okay, so you're not going to be able to do that as easy because you won't be able to lift it up. Okay, so that's the big difference. Okay, so there's how you're holding your bar. Get you nice and close. We're in 3D here, folks. Why the hole's there? I don't know. It don't go all the way through, so it might be... It's not a spit valve, like on a trumpet, so who knows? I'm sure it's there for a reason. But there you go. That's how you hold this thing. Okay, now the main thing we have to do here is once we put the bar on the strings... You can slide it around, get on nasty all you want. The thing we need to do is what's called a damper. Then we'll get on to the fun stuff, I promise. Pardon my thumb. Okay, so what you always want to do is there are lines painted on here. On dobros, there might be actual frets there, but you can't reach them because the strings are just so high off of the body of the guitar. That's what you want. You don't want them way down low. They need to be up high. Those lines are to keep your bar directly in line with that line. You don't want it tilted at an angle like this. You want it right on top of that line, okay? And to follow it perfectly across. So if you play the notes across, it won't sound bad. If you have it tilted, or the other way, it won't sound good until you get it straight and directly on top of that line. That's what they're there for. The dots are to kind of show you where everything is at. The first dot says first fret, third, five, seven, nine. Then it skips a couple and goes right to two dots for a 12th fret. That's where the guitar actually starts over again. So if you have an E string and you take your bar all the way up to that 12th fret where the two dots are, and play that line right past it. It's going to be an E note again. Every string. So that whole thing starts over again. So if you got A minor with your A, C, E, and you need another A minor, you can do it right back there at the 12th fret where those two dots are. And we're going to be playing way up there, so pay attention. The whole thing starts over again there. Then you got your first, your third, your fifth again, seventh, ninth. They all start over again. Then it's guitar starts over again where the double dots are at each time. Okay, so we're going to zoom out. Whoa! Okay, so let's do this just for fun. Let's go up to those double dots and put our slide bar right there. Now, if you play it across with any grouping, do three notes. Let's do your 4, 5, and 6. Okay? 4th string with your thumb. 3rd string with your first finger. We'll zoom in a little bit. And then middle finger. Grabbing your second string. Okay, what do you see here that might prevent your guitar from sounding like mine is if your fingers are not laying on the strings behind your bar, the only two that are left, your pinky and your ring finger, you might end up with... Hear that? That's not good. So if yours sounds like that, it's going to sound like that unless you put those, you don't have to push down at all with them, but just lay them on the strings. That's called a damper. Those are your damper fingers. D-A-M-P, just like pamper, but with a D, damper. Then all of a sudden, that becomes, just by laying that there, it just shuts the strings up. So what you were hearing was these strings back here rattling. If I take my hand off, you'll hear those making noise. At the same time you're trying to do this, so that shuts them up. That is crucial. So always lay whatever fingers you're not using on the strings. Okay? Get one across all of them. That will be your ring finger. If you're missing one, I hope you got a long pinky. Okay? Otherwise, do what you can with the one that's helping you hold. Hopefully you got your middle finger. If you're missing any fingers at all, do what you can with what you have left. Okay? That's all we're getting at. Okay, so now let's do that. The 4, 3, and 2 strings. And let's play them all together. Again, if they're tilted, it's gonna be horrible. Or tilted this way. You want this right on top of that line. So where the double dots are, the line right past it, going this way towards the knobs or whatever you have on here. Okay, so that brings us to our first thing, is I want you to actually go back. This is called a half step, meaning one line backwards this way, up towards where you tune the guitar, okay? So I want you, instead of being at the 12th fret, which is where the double dots are, I want you to go back to 11, and then back to 12. I want you to, instead of doing the staccato, chopping them off thing, I want you to let it ring. I want you to hit those, the 4, 3, 2, all at once. And then I want you to, while that's ringing, take everything, including your damper fingers, move it back one half step, or one line. Okay. So you want to not be moving your bar sideways or like this. Keep it straight as an arrow and get used to moving that just that much. Do it with every grouping you can think of. So grab any three strings. I don't care at this point. Just grab three strings. But now what I want you to practice on really is to bring it back all up to where you were, back up to the 12th fret. So you're, honestly, here's the lesson. I want you to do that. Now, the one last thing for this part of the lesson is what is called vibrato, which is to actually take this bar, shake it without going. It like sounded like somebody put a mouse on top of a record and it's just going all out of whack. I want this. Okay, I'm over dramatizing this thing. But you're not going to be going sideways, sideways, sideways. Again, keep it here. But you got to work with your wrist and your fingers all trying to keep that bar straight across. Now do that with all your groupings, your groups. Uh-oh, we're making music, watch out. Okay, so that's 9/10 of the battle is getting these correct. You don't always have to use three. You can use one note, two notes, three notes. If you want to play with five notes, I don't care. Here's five of them. The guys using the picks can't do that. Go figure. My way's better. Na-na-na-na-na. And I'll show you all that stuff. Okay, so there you go. That's what I want you to work on. Okay, then switch some strings around, skip some. Use your low ones and your high ones only. Okay, so just work doing that on different frets. Okay, these are not actually frets anymore. A fret is a piece of metal that is across there, but these lines represent where frets would be on like a guitar, you know, the metal pieces that go across the neck of a guitar. These are just painted on. So if I use the term frets, these lines are what I'm actually talking about. So wang. Okay, so I'm going down to the fifth fret. Okay, so there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so there's a dot there to let me know I'm there. Then you just go to the line past it. Same thing. Okay, I want you to work on those too. And I want you to also, there's a method to my madness. Why I went from 12, why I went to the 5th fret. Okay, I'm going to call it that from now on. 5th fret, meaning 5th line on there. And then to the 7th fret. Okay, so I want you to remember those. The 12, that is a C chord. Or, yeah. Okay, C6, actually, because we are tuned in C6 if you're playing all these different variations. Okay, when you actually move it down here to the 5th fret, this is now an F, or an F6, actually. And when we move it up to the 7th fret, any combination you want to play is now your G. So you have C, 6th. Everything's going to be followed by the word 6th, okay? So C, F at the 5th, and then at the 7th fret, G. Again, keep those fingers back there. Okay, so now what we're doing here is I'm going to go one other thing, and then we're going to play tons of music. Okay, that's it. One other thing, and we're going to play some music. Instead of just the half step movement, what would a whole step be? Any idea? We went a half a step, which meant one fret behind. What's a whole step? That's right, it means two frets back. Okay, so up here at the 12th fret, we're going to go from the 12th to the 11th to the 10th. Okay, so grab four, three, and two strings. Okay. And I want you to okay. So I want you to play 12, 12th fret, 11, and go back a whole step. So from 12, 11, 10. Okay. That's another cool thing. Now this brings in to where we can actually start to make some music. Okay, so I want you to play anything. I don't care what it is. Get used to this instrument. Okay, I'm the most liberal teacher, but I'm going to teach you more than anybody in the least amount of time. Okay, I'm staying for now on four, three, and two strings for this whole thing. Okay, I want you to do that. Watch my tongue. No, you can't see it from there. Good. Okay, so I'm going to go. So first one, you're going to do staccato, which again just means to chop it off, and then slide up from 11 to 12. When I say from 11 to 12, I mean from the 11th fret or 11th line up to where you back were, up back to where you were. And let it ring, give it some vibrato. Let's try that. So the first one is just staccato, the other ones are ringing. Okay, so then I went same grouping. I'm not getting off 4, 3, and 2 for this whole exercise. So 12th fret, staccato, 11th fret, staccato, and 10th fret, staccato. Or 10th fret, not staccato, I'm sorry, but let it ring and give it some vibrato. Staccato, vibrato, these are going to drive you nuts. So. Uh-oh, here comes music. I'll show you what I just did there in a second. All that fun stuff's coming up, but basics first. Okay, now we're going to go down to the 5th fret, but instead of, that's where we're going to end up, but since we're using a slide, there's a reason it's called a slide, because we're going to slide into the 5th fret. We're going to start with it a half step back. What does that mean? That's right, we start from the 4th fret and slide into home. Okay, up from the 4th fret to the 5th fret. Okay. I'm still playing the same 4, 3, 2 strings. So start with it at the 4th with your bar straight across. Keep your damper fingers there. Did you hear that? You can watch this, okay? That's just going back like a train. Going back that half step. Okay, so we started at the 12th. Oh, music time. Okay, so what I did there is went to climb up to the 7th fret. By doing that, I did the 4th fret, 5th fret, 6th fret, and then 7th fret. And then a half step move from 7, 6, 7. That meaning 7th fret, 6th fret, 7th fret, all sliding. Okay, so there we have that. So now that's what we got to do. We got to do the 12th fret. Okay, so let it ring, let it ring, let it ring, let it ring. Okay, now we go. Now 4th fret. Okay. Then staccato, slide it back into it. Okay, again. You can definitely make it slide. You want to make it cry, boy. Let's do it. Down to the 4th fret. Okay, so we went. Right into that 5th fret. Then we're gonna Enrico the seventh, but in order to do so, like I said, I want you to go, which is all staccato, okay? So we got 4th fret, 5th fret, 6th. Just shake the whole heap of Jesus out of that thing. Then I'm going back down chromatically. There's a new word, which means every fret. So from 7 to 5, chromatically down. So that means 7, 6, 5. So I don't have to keep saying 7, 6, 5. That's your word of the day, chromatically. So 7, 6, 5. So we just went chromatically. Ah, oh, my computer's alive. Blue screen of death, imagine that. Okay, anyway, so 7, 6, 5. Some vibrato. Then we're going to go back up to the 12th, finally. But, hey, I hear you. But we don't just go there, do we? No, we go a half step again into it. And do our little train sound again. So what we have, I'll swoop out. I don't know which one is in or out, but that's a guy for you. Okay, that's cool. You slide it all the way down. And then come back up to it. There's your chromatic. So that's everything so far, okay? So once again. Fourth fret up into the fifth. Then 4, 5, 6, 7. That's all chromatic. That last little bit that you just heard that is like, how do you do it? How do you do it? No secret. Same position. You're back up here to the 12th fret. Hit your thumb. And just go back a half step and back to where you were. So, then 3rd fret, or 3rd string. 2nd string. 1st string. So, the big thing there is to, just check it out. You know, just to play it. Play around with it. Now all I'm doing, while we're here, we're going to make the most of what we have so far. Then for the next hour after this, then we'll actually get into the crazy stuff. But so what I'm doing, let's zoom back in, what the hey. That is your typical country pattern. Okay, so 3 chords we had are C, we had F, I'll tell you why they are what they are later, and then we had G. If you want to know, your cheating heart is played with these three chords, okay? And I'll show you how to play that song also in this video. Okay, this is just going to get fancy on you. Not at all, no. It's just not playing a group. Okay, so right now, real quick, try all the other groups with, like I said, don't know which way's in, which way's out. Go to 6, 5, 4, the low ones. Okay, do it 5, 4, 3. Then our favorite sounding one, 4, 3, 2. And then, we never even tried any of these. Now let's try 3, 2, 1. Okay, so that's blasting through at breakneck speed for a lot of you. Thing now is to use different groupings. Okay, so now I want you to don't follow everything I do note for note. Try it the way I show it to you, then mess around. This is where you're going to find all the fun stuff. Use different groupings. It does not matter. That's what's cool about the C6 tuning is you can't really screw up. Okay, so grab string number 6 and string number 2 and string number 1. It don't matter. Grab something else. There's 5, 3, and 2. You don't have to stick with those. Change as you go. There, I used all 6 strings at some point. Now I'm using 4 fingers. 4, 3, 2, 1. I'm going. So a 7th fret. Just doing a roll. So thumb, first finger, second finger, third finger. So that was 7th fret doing a roll. It's pretty, isn't it? Okay. So there's so many things. Don't just do the groups. Mess around. I'll show you how to do that. Let's do it now. Why not? Okay, we'll just do it open, meaning without your bar. We're going to go on 4th string, 3rd string, 2nd string, string. So those 3 strings again. I'm going to come in close so you can see what is another roll. This is actually called a banjo roll. Okay, let's see if my auto focus will work here. Okay, there we go. So thumb on your 4th finger, like always, on your 4th finger, on your 4th string. Then, so those 4, 3, 2. Now I want you to do it differently. I want you to play the 4th string, 2nd string, then your 3rd string. Okay, notice how your thumb is like, could be way out far away from them. That is cool. But I'm stopping each one. By putting my appendage back on it. Or you can let them ring. So that is the order. So thumb, middle, first finger. Work on doing that and try it with your bar on there. And you move it all the way across all the strings. See, I'm moving my bar. It covers all 6 strings, but sometimes you just want to concentrate one area. So it's okay to put your bar where you want it as long as it's still straight across. There will be a point later on where it's going to be important for you to move your bar back and forth and grab certain places and pick it up. Okay? So that's a banjo roll. Get used to playing that. There's no other way than to say, hey, do that. Okay? You do that on your time. I'm not going to waste a whole bunch of time on the video going over that. But that's a must. Okay? Reason being, it develops speed and agility for other things, not just for that. Okay, without that, knowing that, I wouldn't have been able to do what I just did. So you got all these different things you can do with your fingers. Again, why I like to use my fingers and not the picks. But that's up to you. Like I said, 99% of the world uses the picks. Why? Because they think they're supposed to. That's why. Okay. So more fun with this. With this same exact thing. Now, I told you, the whole guitar starts again right here. So this C chord is actually the same as... Okay? Only thing we can't do with it being open is we can't go from open back a half step. That's why I have you all the way up here at the 12th. Because you can't do that here. My bar just ends up going off into space. That's why I started your way up there. Okay? And also, remember, when we went to the 5th fret, okay, I want you to find the 5th fret again, but an octave higher. Okay, so how do we do that? I'm going to solve it for you. Okay, I'm not going to make you sit here and hunt and peck for things. That's why I'm here. I'm here to show you stuff. So you have 5th fret here, which we've already went to. Again, I'm going to stay at 4, 3, and 2 as far as my grouping. That's where I'm going to go for 90% of this stuff. But I want you to search all over the place because nothing is invalid. You can play any strings. Sounds like a whole song there just by doing group 1, group 2, group 3, group 4. So many songs are played that way. You're probably recognizing some already. Try that. Yeah, you're going to find tons of stuff that just depends on you doing a half step. And just change your group. So this is group 1, group 2, group 3, group 4. Group 1 meaning the low strings. Group 2, group 3, group 4. So you just start one string different each time. Okay, so again, 5th fret. We want to find the 5th fret again. Little hint, it's actually going to be the 17th fret, but how do we know it's the 5th fret, and how do we do it easy so we don't have to think about it? The guitar starts over again where we've been starting. So where is it again? Well, it's actually going to be up here to this dot right up here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 more frets. So it's going to be where the dot is. Now we're getting way up there. Same thing. Make sure you're muting your strings back here. You got your damper fingers. Now when you start getting up this high, you got to really pay attention to your bar that it's not sideways. Okay, so get up there. You're at the 15th fret, which is actually, 17th fret, which is the same as what you were here. And that's a good thing to work on, going from there and sliding right up into it without screwing up. You've heard this a lot of times. You get people to do that. Okay, I'll teach you that too. But work on trying to go from, this is called an octave, from the 5th fret all the way up to the 17th. So you, here you are with your F chord. Without letting anything die out on you. You're just pressing hard enough on your bar. I should have added just enough to get sound out of it. You don't want to press down real hard or the guitar is going to be way out of tune sounding. So an hour later, there's that fact. And learn to stop there. Okay, so same thing as before. I just want you to make sure you got that and you can get there and to know that those are the same. So if you went from 5 or 7 chromatically up, 5 chromatically up to 7, 5, 6, 7, what can you do here? That's right, same thing. So pretend you're on 5 again. Here's where it gets very Western sounding. Okay, so now don't use the low ones. Now we're going to use 12th fret and do what you did before. Now we're going to move up to this, pretend that was the 5th fret, even though it's 17th and 18th and 19th. But you're just looking at it the same as you were before. You just don't have as much room to work with because the lines get closer together or the frets get closer together. So same thing as before, but work on it up here now. Okay, so now you're at 12th. So you're sneaking up just like the 4th fret to the 5th. I'm just changing groupings. You can do that here too. Okay. So making sense. So we're just playing an octave higher. The guitar started over here. So now that is 0. That's 12th fret, even though that's 0, just like this thing here called the nut. That is zero, okay? So there's nothing there. There's no lines, there's nothing. So the guitar does start again. So you're at zero or 12, then you go up to the fifth fret, supposedly, and fourth. Do exactly what you were doing before. But when you get way up here, by golly, then you're talking vintage country, okay? Change your groupings to whatever you want them to be. Do not listen to me. And just stay on four, three, and two. Change them around. I'm going up to the seventh fret, or actually the 19th fret, but. Play one string at a time. Or change, or do the. Okay, that's the banjo roll, but way up high. Changing groupings. Okay, so you see what's happening here is we have this at the 12th fret, and we now have fifth after the seventh, and also we've just changed it. We've added two more, but they're the same thing. We now have the option to go. And accomplish the same thing, but if you're doing like the verse of a song where it's nice and easy, now it's time for you to solo. So then you know you want to go way up high and do some fun soloing stuff. You want to hear something cool? That's right, your cheating heart is played way up there. You want to learn to play that? I'll teach you some of this, okay? I actually get to switch digital audio tapes and throw in another one for a second hour. So the screen's going to go, ooh. I know it takes me more time to tell you about it than actually do it, but that's half the fun. Just letting my mouth run and run and run. Okay, so here we go. Okay, we're back. I promise you that I'm going to show you part of your cheating heart here, and I'm actually going to let you play along with it too. Okay, I've used this on one of my other videos, but it applies so much better to this one. It will just basic three chord song, and actually the three that I've showed you, the C, F, and G, or C, F, and G. That's why I taught you all this stuff, because your cheating heart is the perfect example for how to play the C6 instrument. It's what was used on it, okay? There was no other thing. Okay, they had steel guitars that had like 10 different necks on them, it was like all tuned differently. But the pedals weren't out yet, so. Anyway, so here's the actual recording. You hear those half-step things, don't you? Where they're going, you know what I mean already. How do we play it? You already know, believe it or not. That's right, everything we've used so far. Remember I told you to come up and do these octaves? That's where we're going to be at. All the way up here to what you'll think is the 7th fret, but it's actually the 19th fret. Okay, so from 12, you're counting up 7, or come up to what's going to be my third dot. I don't know if you got an, you should not have a dot here. So, third dot past the double dots. Okay, so there's 5 and then 7 again. So up here to this 7th. Listen to it one last time, and then I'll show you how to play it. That much there, okay? We're way up here. Okay? That's why I'm showing you all these half-step things, okay? Let's put it at an angle we can deal with, okay? We are playing with our two fingers. We're only going to be playing with two fingers on a thumb most of the time. You're playing strings one and two. You're going back a half step from the seventh or the 19th fret, whatever you want to call it. I'm going to call it the seventh, okay? So, and play those two strings. You want to really emphasize the first string. Okay? But, so each one is a half step and then slide into it each time, three times. And then what did I do? You'll see. So three times on those two strings, on the first string and second string. Now we're gonna go with your thumb on the fourth string and your first finger on the second string. Half step and slide into it. These half steps are as important as strings on here are. Okay, so half steps for every flipping thing. Again. Okay, so that was thumb on fourth fret. Or fourth string, I'm sorry. And then first finger on your second string. So it's. And then this part. Okay, I'll show you one extra note. Okay, here's where it gets kind of funky. So we have. Okay, the one time we have to bend the bar. Okay, we're actually going to be trying to do that 19th fret or the 7th fret. Okay, so that's what we're trying to do, is bend the bar now finally. And we're going to try to cover what is now going to be called our 8th fret. On your second string. So we take it from here, we still keep the low part on your fourth string at the seventh fret or your 19th fret, and then you actually try to cover on the second string this fret, okay? So your 20th fret or your 8th fret, however you want to look at it. So you got to cover both those. In order to do that, you have to bend the bar. So you got to put this right on top of that note, and instead of that, it has to be there. So you have to cover both of those and then slide a half step into it. Okay, very strange, but you get used to this because it's a cool thing. And as you can tell in this song, it's a must. So this is the only time you get to bend the bar is for things like this. And again, half step. Okay, so back to what we had. Then, so you start with it a half step low, or, okay, well, that gets taken some use to, because you got to get those notes right, otherwise, but those damper fingers, keep them down there, so that's where that part is, it's hard. Then, okay, so that's what you're doing is covering those. Then finally, is the easy stuff. So that's the hardest thing you're going to do today, is that. Okay, so that there. So after the, you're actually doing the four string and your two string, but you're starting at the 11th fret, sliding a half step to your 12th. Okay, it's nice and firm, really. So like, don't even sound like you're sliding into it, just trying to get from one to the other as quick as you can. Then, just like we started, your first finger, or your first string, your first finger too, first and second string, first and second finger, going from 11 to 12, 11 to 12, 11 to 12, half step. So just like we started. Okay, so we're doing the same thing down here, just differently. Okay, and that's the intro to your cheating heart.
Okay.
Okay, so that's it. I'm not going to waste any more time on it, but that's how you do it, kids. I actually am going to, at this point, play this song and just let it play without me doing anything. I'm going to show you for the first 30 seconds of it or so how you can mess around. That's what I want you to do, is take this song as much as you can, use that 12th fret, that 5th fret, and that 7th fret. So C, F, and G, and again here, C, F, and G, and remember your half steps, and on your 12th fret, you can go the half step or a whole step before going to your fifth or your fifth. You can always go down a whole step before you go right to that chord and then slide into half steps, half steps. Play with banjo rules, play with different groupings. Play with everything that I've given you so far on this song. I'll do about 30 seconds from there. And you can play whatever you want. And that's what I'm going to do. I'm not going to play what's on here. I'm going to play what I want. You're going to come up with something different. It's from the 12th, either to the 2 frets ahead or a whole step up, or to the 2nd fret here. So a whole step up. That's the only difference in this song. So back just a little bit. We'll go right into it again from here. Idea. I want you to play with the whole song. I'm just going to let it go, and you just make up junk as you go. The best thing to do is take what I've showed you, and remember, you cannot hit a wrong string, okay? So use all the strings. Use all your abilities to just be creative, okay? That's what this is all about. You cannot screw up as long as you follow the change, okay? I will actually stay on video. I'll go out as far as I can, and I'll offer position suggestions. It'll only be here 5 or 7, or here 5 and 7, or whatever you want to call it, actually 17 and 19. And then the other one will be that 2, or up a whole step from the 12, which will be the 14th fret, or just to the 2nd fret. Okay, so I will be offering silent, not suggestive movements. That'd get you thrown in jail. I don't care who you are. That's funny right there. Get her done! Okay, so here we go. I'm just going to play it. Let you do what you want. Okay, I'm going to shut up. And if you ever need to look and see where we're actually at, I will show you that. I will but not be doing a whole bunch of wah, wah, wah. Actually, I'll get rid of my slide bar and I'll just point to what fret you're supposed to be at, okay? Here we go. And like I said, you can either be here at the 5th fret or here at the 5th fret. Okay? It's your choice. Do whatever you want. Here goes the song from the beginning. I'll crank it up so you have something to fire away to. Hit it, Hank.
Sleep. sleep won't come the whole night through. Your cheating heart will tell on you. When tears come down like falling rain, you'll toss around and call my name. You'll walk the floor the way I do.
Hope you like that ending. Okay, if you want that, just for fun, that was just your, just a grouping of two. Your thumb on the third string, your first, and then your first string. Okay, so they're just skipping a string, doing a half step into it. Then four and two strings. Then that two, that three and one again. So that was it. So it's just a matter of how you, if you want to do two strings, three. Or you could go with the original winners. And that's all there is. Okay, so one of the coolest songs, one of the easiest songs to practice with. So practice with that all you can. Okay, that's the only song I'm going to leave on here for you to play with. What I need to do now is show you how to play in all these different keys and how to play single notes. Okay, I'm going to give you a quick lesson in how to play single notes. In order to do so, I'm going to zoom out a little bit. I am not good with this zoom button. I'm going to go to the open position, which is still C, but just like you were playing up here on the 12th fret. Okay, so now what we can do to actually look at this whole thing, if you can take your hand and lift it up, lift up your bar. Again, you're only putting as much pressure on the strings as you need to make a note sound. If you don't put enough on it, you'll get that. Okay, so just, you're not pushing down at all. You're just laying the bar on there. That's all you gotta do, is just lay it on there. And the top of your finger, right here, this finger on top, not the top of your finger, but this finger on top is what determines how much force you're pushing down on there with. And you don't need to push at all. At all. Okay, there's the microphone. I'm sure it hopes I brushed my teeth, which I did. So hope you guys are safe at home. Okay. Okay, so there's what is called a scale. There's certain notes that you can use if you want to play individual notes. Or Okay, so all these different notes that you can play. Okay, so across this, just really quickly, and then we'll transfer it to some other things and then get on with it. Okay, so just to show you this, so your lowest string, your C string, okay, you can keep your bar off. Now put it on the second fret. You can practice just doing this all day long. I'm not doing nothing with my other hand. So know you got it right. Now doing the next string, okay, your E string here. And then going to the first fret. So you have, okay, so open, sixth fret, or sixth string, I'm sorry, second fret, now open on your fifth string, first fret, now we're doing fourth string, open, third string, open, third string, second fret. Second fret, or second, I do that all the time. Second string, second fret, okay? So same thing. First string, first fret. Now third fret, first fret. Open, second string, second fret, open, third string, second fret, open, fourth string, open, fifth string, first fret, now open, sixth string, second fret, now open. Okay, so that's a whole scale. That is. Okay, so there's that. So actually, honestly, work on that, because I want you to be able to do it again up here at the 12th fret. And now think about it. Instead of those open strings, they have to be here at the 12th fret. So now you're. And you gotta think about it, but I want you to be able to do that everywhere. Reason being, if you're playing, now I want you to be able to incorporate this and use it to play melody lines. What I mean by that, if you're in C, but you wanna play something that sounds like something, play those one-line notes and know what they are, and that pattern will be the same no matter where you're at. If you're here on the fifth fret, same thing applies. Okay, so you have to keep that pattern in your head. So if you're here at the fifth fret, last time, then we got to move on because I got a lot to show you. Fifth, okay, I'm just going to tell you, show you the strings with my thumb. So fifth fret, seventh fret, then back to the fifth fret again on the next string. Sixth fret, now we're at the fifth fret again, next string. And the next string, fifth fret, seventh fret, next string, fifth fret, seventh fret, and last string finally. Fifth fret, six, and I'm sorry, yeah, five, six, eight, and then backwards. Okay, so learn that. That is just something for you to really, you're gonna need. You're gonna see a lot of this in the next actual video. Remember that? Thank you. comes in handy. So work on that. You can see how it will be handy. So there's a lot to be done there. Okay, let's now change to different keys. Okay, we've been working out of this whole C thing the whole time. I'm not gonna, you can find out what the keys are, what the chords are, I'm sorry, on online, anywhere. I'm gonna tell you how to do that and waste 2 minutes of your day by giving you the most important information you can get. Go to roughstock.com, rough, R-O-U-G-H, stock, S-T-O-C-K.com, or, and then there will be a little section there called Cow Pie. I know, as stupid as it is, Cow Pie, C-O-W-P-I-E. And that will be every country song in the world in there, the lyrics, and what chords are being played with it. So C, F, and G. And then we actually went from C to D when we went up to the whole step on Your Cheating Heart, C to D. Okay, and the other thing is, it'll show you all those chords, when they're played on top, it'll show you right when they change. You can print them out, have the song, download the song, whatever, play along with them, and it shows you right what word it is to change to what chord. How much easier can it be? So that's where you get all the old songs. Roughstock.com, then there'll be a little link there called Cow Pie, and then you can pick by the artist alphabetically or by the name of the song, whatever song you want. It's there. It tells you what all the chords are, when they change, blah, blah, blah. Okay, so go get those. Now, how do we find out where those chords are at on the guitar? Everything is like this, okay? So use your low C string to gauge where you are at. So there's C, okay? What things do for all you beginners is, check this out. Write it down or just go online and get it. Here is how everything goes on that string only. That's the only string I'm going to show you. So there's C. Then I'm going to go a half step each time and give you the name. Write them down. I'm not even going to flash them on the screen. Write this down. So from C, C sharp, first fret. Okay, now I'm going to just go a half step each time. So C, C sharp. Sharp is indicated by a number sign, like a tic-tac-toe sign. So C, C sharp. Here we go. D. Third fret is going to be D sharp. Fourth fret is going to be E. Then it goes directly to F. There's no sharp on the seventh fret. On the fifth fret, I'm sorry. So fifth fret, where we've been playing, was your F. Okay, F. Now sixth is going to be F sharp. Seventh is G, what we were playing before. This one is G. Eighth fret is G sharp. Then everything starts over, and the beginning of the alphabet on the ninth fret is A. Now we can see we're getting close to the 12th fret. So A on the ninth fret, A sharp on the 10th. 11th is B. And then there's no B sharp at all. It goes straight to C. Now we're right back to the beginning again. So if you wrote all those down, here we go quick. C, C sharp, D, D sharp, E, F, F sharp, G, G sharp, A, A sharp, B, and finally back to C. Okay, so if you want to know where a note's at, like a chord, like D, how do you find it? We went C, C sharp, D, that means there's a D chord. Okay, now the cool thing to find out about three chord songs, which most country songs are, okay, is the fact that once you find out what key the song is in by moving your bar around to find out, okay, it sounds like the majority of the song is here. What is that? Okay, it's a D. Okay, I know where to go, so you go, if I'm in D, I know just because it's going to be D, G, and A, but where are G and A? And how do I know that's what you're talking about? So a country song that isn't the key of D, the two other chords that are going to be in the song 99% of the time are going to be G and A. Okay, so you'll get to find a G. How do we do it? We either look at our paper or we figure this out. So what do we do? So there's C or D, D sharp, E, F, F sharp, G. Okay, there's G and A. So there's G, G sharp, A. Okay, here's the easiest way to find out. Okay, if you already know what key you're in the key of D, all you gotta do is count up 5 frets. Say from there, go up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's gonna be your next chord in the song. That's gonna be your G. And then up 2 more is gonna be your A, or your third chord. So I just went to the 2nd fret for our D. I'm playing the low string, and then the top 2 strings. Because that gives you a good, solid, full chord. That's a nice grouping. Lucky that low, since we're in D, has room for us to mess around with. Actually got enough room to slide down there. And then we do everything the same as we've been doing. But now we know what chords to use. Okay, so this is now D and G, A, and how do we get back to another D? It was on the 2nd fret. Go past the 12 and go up 2 frets. So we have... And again, same thing. You know that you're here. So what do? You go up to that familiar G that we've been playing, but we gotta go up 5 frets. So from here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, way up here. Then up 2 more frets to get your 3rd chord. Okay, so that's what it is. Whatever key you're in, so there's D, 6th, because we are in a 6th-tuned instrument, okay? We can do everything we've already done. What did I do? Same thing we did down here. Same thing that you were doing before. Okay, so that's how you do that. Let's find, I'm going to give you a chord. I want you to find it, okay? I know it's time consuming, but we're going to spend 5 minutes doing this, okay? I want you to put me in the key of A. And I want you to tell me what 3 chords would actually be used. This is going to rack your brain. So you might as well just pause this whole thing, whatever you're using, and pause it. I want you to find me the A. The song is going to be in the key of A. So I want you to tell me where the closest, starting from down here, where A is. And then figure out on your own what the other 2 chords are and where they're going to be. Okay, so just pause this sucker, because I'm going to just come right back and get it, okay? So pause it now. Key of A. Find the A chord and the other 2 chords that would be in your typical country song. Pause now. Okay, so we come back. Where are you? Okay, where the heck is A? I don't know. Where are you at? Where is your bar? Okay. Where should it be? I'll tell you exactly where it should be. If you're looking for A, and you made the chord correctly, your bar will be at the 9th fret. Is that where it is? Count them up. Is your bar at the 9th fret? What does that mean? Hopefully you know this by now. Okay. So is your bar at the ninth fret? You tell me. Okay. So you should be at the ninth fret. Okay. What is the ninth fret? You know what it is. Now, if you did not get there, you got to go back and figure out why you didn't get it. No, you don't. I'll give it to you real quick. Because A is on this C string, your low string, you should have counted up by those things I just gave you until you learn exactly where all these are at, which you have to do, so you can find them fast instead of counting. You only got to memorize, 11 notes, then it all starts over again. So you got to memorize C, C sharp, blah, 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 what's written down the napkin or whatever you put it on. So C, C sharp, D, D sharp, E, F, F sharp, G, G sharp, A. That's how we found out that we're going to end up right up here. Okay, so there's that. Okay, now we got to find the other two chords that are going to be in here. What did I say before to do? Start from here and count up 5 frets. So you keep that as 0, or your home base, your root is actually what it's called. The key that your song is in, A, is your root. Okay? So if they say go back to the root chord or the one chord, that's what they mean, go there. Now we count up 5 frets. You do not start here. That is 0. You got to go up 5. So up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's actually going to put you on the 14th fret. Okay? But it is past the double fret markers, or the 12th fret where it starts over. So where did you end up? On the 14th fret. Or, if you think about it, starting from here, because we want to go to the lowest notes possible for now to prove a point and to learn. So from here, you went up 2 frets. So let's do that. Since we found out where it is and what it is, what is it? You can count from here because it starts over. C, C sharp, D. Okay. So it's going to be a D. Okay. So we know that we can go here. It's only 2 frets past where the guitar started over. So we can just go to fret number 2. And it'll be the same thing. So we had A. Okay. And then we have D. And how did I say to go to the next one? Just up another whole step from there, or 2 frets. And there's E. So you have A, we have D, and up 2, and back to here. So that should be what you found, or that up here at the 14th, and then the 16th, and back to A. Okay, so that's what I was trying to get you to find, was those 3 chords. If you did not do it successfully, I'm going to give you one more, okay? I want you to do it in the key of E. Okay, so the key of E. Go find E and the other 2 chords that would go in a song that is in the key of E. Go. Pause this thing. Go. Okay, so we are back. Where is E? You should already know because we've already played it. Just not 30 seconds ago. Okay, so how do we find E? Okay, where's your bar at for E? What fret are you on? Okay, it had better be the 4th fret. Okay, at this point you should have figured this out. 4th fret. Why? C, C sharp, D, D sharp, E. Plus we just got done doing A, D, and E. So you should have already known that was going to be E. What are the other 2 chords? Well, let's find out. Okay. That will be them. Okay, what are they? E, A, and B. Hopefully you named them also and did it ahead of what I'm telling you. So it's E, A, and B. Where's A? That's where we just started on the last one when I told you to find A. How did we get there? You go up 5 frets from your E that we did at the 4th fret. So now you go up One, two, three, four, five. So now you're at the 9th fret. And then your B is going to be two more frets past that. One and two at the 11th fret. So now we have 4, 9, and 11. So E, A, B, back to A, and back to E. If we want to go to E there, it's only 4 frets past the beginning, or past the nut, 4 frets. You can look at it real quick. That's 3 frets where the dot is past the nut, or just go to the 4th fret, just the E like we did here. E, that's going to be E again. So you can go A, up to B, up to E again. Slide into it. That's right, it's up at the 16th fret, 16. But it looks like the 4th fret because the guitar starts over. So these are the things you got to figure out, okay? And do them in every key. Work on them, try to figure these out. Again, go to roughstock.com, hit cowpie, and you'll find the chords written out for you already. Print them out, play with all your songs, put them on your stereo or whatever you have. Print that out, find those chords. You know how to do it now. You've written it down. I told you the way to go from the one, or your root, and count it up 5 frets, and then just up 2 more frets, and you'll find all these chords. Okay, so do that. That's your homework assignment. Go to cowpie and go get songs that you like and use what I have showed you to play along with them. Okay, so let me grab, just for the fun of it, okay, I'm gonna grab you one more song just to play along with. I'm looking through my computer, so you will get to hang around with me. Let's do Merle Haggard. I love Merle Haggard. Let's do that. what a good one. Big City. Big City is in the key of E, the one we just did, the key we just did, so 4th fret, and then up here to the 9th fret for your A, then up to the 11th for your B, and then you can go all the way up to the 16th if you want to for this. Here's Big City, what it sounds like. Let's get her on here. Come here, Merle. By golly. Here's Merle. He'll be loud. This is going to be bringing up another good point. There's steel right there. Okay, now these chords are in a different order. Everybody drink. Are in a different order than the other song, than your cheating heart. Okay, I'm going to throw these out here. I'm going to yell out the chords to you as they change. Okay, and you, here's E. Here's A at the 9th, B at the 11th, and then E again back to the 4th or the 16th. Of course, your 9th can go. You can bring it way the heck up there. You know how to find this now. I'm going to tell you the chords now just by E, A, and B. Okay, here's E, A, and B. Now you play along any way you want. You cannot hit wrong notes, but remember to do. All that junk that you've already learned. It's just a matter of groupings and to go down a half step and slide into it, same as we've been doing the whole time. I'm gonna yell the chords out as the song goes. Then I'm gonna let it play by itself, okay? I'm going to go ahead and put my fingers like before as I'm yelling them out and after. Okay, so here's Big City, key of E. So it's E, A, and B. You can watch here. Here comes my loud voice with it. E. A. Back to
B. Back to E. Stay there in E.
I'm tired.
Play what you want. E. A. Back to E.
Too much work.
We're staying there.
And
B. How would you know this? Go to Rustock.
And I'm
E. You'll get to it. A. You'll get used to it when they change what it sounds like. Back to E. B. E. It goes that quick.
Turn me
E.
Set me free.
Up to A.
Somewhere in the middle of
back to E. You're playing whatever you want. You're still there. Now B. Back to E. Bam, bam, bam. A.
So
far. Man. So far. So far. So far. Way up here.
Exit it. Turn me.
B. Back to E. And we're still in E. And A. Back to E. And B. And back to E. Oh, I went up there. Look at that. So
been
E still.
Every day since I was
A. E. If I wanted to, I could play along. B. E. A. Back to E. B. E. So E. Proving a point. You can do whatever you want. A. Back to E.
Give me all I've got.
You're still there.
Come
whatever you want. There's B. And E. Up to
and
A.
So so
and back to E. And you're still at E. And B.
Set free.
Back to E. E. And B. And E. And E way up here if you want. Hey, I'm going to hold it like this. I'm going to play the song one more time, and I'm going to shut my pie hole and let you just play along with it. Okay? So there's the chords. Just three chords. I'm going to shut up. Here goes the song again. I'll just hold the steel this way so you can easier see what I'm doing. I'll just kind of do this. Okay? So key of E. E and B. Here we go.
Social security.
Okay, so hopefully that helped you out. Sorry for my skipping on my computer. How does the song skip on there? Who knows? Okay, so hopefully you had luck with that. Like I said, practice every little thing I've taught you. Just to go over for the last couple minutes what we've been through. While you were playing that song, and now go back and do this when I show you these things. Okay, we're in the key of E. Okay, I'm going to zoom out just a little bit. Okay, so we're at the 4th fret. I'm in the key of E. Okay, now while you're doing everything that you were doing that have fun with, you know, doing all the fun that this tuning allows you for and doing your groupings, now go back, play the song, and try to do those scales, that scale that I showed you. Okay, so there's things you can do there. Okay, so you can actually play. You didn't show me that. Yeah, I did. That was when I showed you that whole scale thing. So these are just one, covering the bases here. So it's that same pattern we did earlier, but try to incorporate that in with all the other fun stuff. You know, because you can actually start building on things. Just put a couple of the notes in there, not the whole thing, but it adds so much. You know, so that's what I'm getting at, is to try to incorporate that stuff in, and the old, okay, that is cool. That is just simply the E, playing 3-2-1 as far as the strings go, doing the chromatic, one fret at a time, walk down. And doing this is called a gliss when it goes down, like on a piano, and Jerry Lee Lewis goes brrr. That's called a gliss. Anytime something goes down like that. Okay, so do those. It's just. It's just kind of cool. So you were at E. So I'm just using notes out of that scale. So that's basically as far as we can go with this 2-hour lesson. So you're introduced to the instrument, You're aware of everything you have to have, all your strings, whether you want to use picks or fingers. Up to you, depends on the sound you want, okay? So I like it like this, but like I said, 99% of the people use those picks, okay? So work with those and decide if you like those picks. Don't just play it like this because I do, okay? Do your own thing. That's what makes you unique. Don't just sit here and copy me. Use this as a building thing. I'm throwing you the tools. You get out there and build the house, okay? So again, incorporate all this junk, but remember all your different groupings. Don't keep them in groups of three. Play two strings. Okay, you know what I'm talking about. Okay, now the last thing I need to tell you about are minor chords. Okay, when you go to rough stock and you get these chords, sometimes it's gonna say, okay, time for you to play, I don't know, like say you're in the key of, let's go with A. We're way back up here again. Okay, now we have an A string here, but now it's not gonna be A when we're playing up here. Only the strings that were C are gonna be A's now. So I need to find A minor. Remember at the beginning when we're tuning this thing, I said something spells out ace, A, C, E, the way the strings are tuned. That's actually A minor, because that's the A note. So if you need if I'm in the key of A, okay, in the key of A, let's look at it. There would probably be a F sharp minor. Okay, and that is actually what is already here. If A, A sharp, B, C, C sharp, D, D sharp, E, F, F sharp, I'm counting all this off of the A string. So learn to count up. So there's A, or I'm sorry, F sharp minor, or F sharp actually. On the G, on the D, A string, third string. So if I just play the ace, those three strings, God, I need to get rid of my tongue. That's actually F sharp minor. So we're actually in A. So if I need a minor chord, that's how I just found it. It's gonna be relative to the chord that you're already in. So if you're in A, probably, if you're on a cow pie and it asks for an F sharp minor, that's probably going to be your ACE strings, but just those three strings. That'll give you your F sharp minor. But check it against, you know, that's an A string because ACE, A, so A, A sharp, B, you know, all the way up C, C sharp, D, D sharp, E, F, F sharp. Then whatever you play after that on ace will be a minor, so there's F sharp minor. So if it asks for F, then the number sign sharp, and then a small M for minor on one of these rough stock things, you'll know how to find it. Okay, so if I'm playing along in the key of A, and then I go to D, second fret, to A. I'm leaving out that A string. To E. Then it all of a sudden wants F sharp. Minor. Okay, so A. And then the F sharp minor. I can actually add the fifth string in, just to fill it in, back to A, E, and I'm just leaving that third string alone, just to make everything major sounding. So if you ever want everything straight, leave out that A string, that third string. Play everything around it. But when you want it to sound like this old that stuff, that's why that A string is tuned that way. That's what gives you that sixth sound, is anytime you play that string. Okay, so anyway, there's all that. There's so much to cover, and you can only do so much in 2 hours, so that gives you a good, huge head start into all this. But use those, remember, you can always creep up on it, half step, back to it, then slide in. But add the licks in from the... Okay, so there's all that fun stuff. Incorporate every little piece into there, okay? So you got so many things to work on. Go back, get every little thing. All that stuff and all the little things. Go back, check them all, play along with these songs till you're sick of them. Make sure you can find out every chord there is in the world. Find out where F sharp is normally, find out where B flat is. Flats are actually, if you count them backwards, if you have C here, there's B, then you call it B flat or A sharp, either way. So if you're going down, people call them that. There's A flat, G flat, all that stuff, you know. So that's just stuff you need to get all together. So it's like, man, where's the E? It's here. I already know that. So you got to know that C string like the back of your hand. Okay, so that's all I got time for there. Here comes my outro and we're out of here. Okay, so practice all that junk. Cram it all together. Okay? Okay, well, there you go. A heap load of information for you. Hope you enjoyed that. And there will be another video coming out so you can advance with this. But there's plenty of time, plenty of stuff for you to work on to actually get used to it and to actually, you can take this thing on a stage and play it now if you actually learn everything that's on here. So, there you go. Same exact licks, whether it's a dobro or whether it's a lap steel, as long as it's tuned in C6th. There it is. You're ready to get down and twang out with your bad self. Okay, so once again, be able to check out, be sure to check out all my other videos. There are other lap steel and dobro videos. I got pedal steel stuff coming up too. There'll be more C6 stuff too and other tunings coming out. So once again, Scott Grove, hope you enjoyed yourself. Get out there, play loud, and yeehaw! That's what it's all about, kids. Take care.